Alright, so today I have a bunch of these root beer barrels that I need to get painted. So I guess that's what we're going to do. Alright, so first, I guess I'll start with these little lines. So I just spent like an hour trying to get in here, and I know it's ridiculously retarded and I shouldn't even admit to it, but there was a wasp in here, and it's the only thing in the world that scares me. So yeah, that was a fun battle, but in the end I finally won. I guess everybody has to be scared of something. Mine is wasps and bees. And of course I'm always like, go get it, Kaden. But I think, you know, your kids pick up stuff from you, the way you act, and so even Kaden's slightly paranoid now. I'm doing this where you can kind of see. Knowing me, I'm not. But I had to make more of these guys last night to fill some more orders, so it happens. Never know if you make enough the first time. I'm always paranoid to make too many with the Rebel boxes because I don't know how many orders I'm going to get each month, so I kind of make them as I need them, to be honest. So now, if I don't get very many more orders before the 15th, then I'll have some extra of these, and I guess people will be getting them in mystery boxes and giveaways. I still feel like a kid. Kind of trying to fill in the lines a little bit. Just using dry powder. I think last time I wetted a little bit, which it looks like I might need to do to get it to... No, it's showing up pretty good on camera. not showing up. I don't know whether to leave this room in this close or let you guys see everything I'm doing, but that's okay. I'll just focus on the ones you can see right here. So this color that I'm using is actually green, which is what color the embeds are inside of here, green and blue. So I picked it because it looks brown, but it's not. So it'll look good in the water when it activates green, but for decoration wise, it's brown like I want it to be. So I guess now you guys know my fears. I know Funk freaked out when I put a centipede in one of her bath bombs, so I'm sure one of these days I'll open a box and have a bee or a wasp sitting in there from somebody. Fake one, I hope, but you know. My mother has learned from going out with me that I don't tolerate them well, and sometimes she likes to mess with me. But it's really so bad, you guys, that okay. They're especially in like the garden section of Walmart and stuff. I've been known to practically crawl out of there. I went to Jamesport with my mom not that long ago, and there was a huge bumblebee flying around in the store, and so I was crouching at the counter trying to pay for my stuff. Thankfully, the girl at the checkout kinda understood and was terrified too, which is why it was still in there. She was like, I ain't getting up and killing that thing. But I didn't care. I paid for my stuff and ran across the street. But looking back on it now, I feel worse for her having to sit in there all day with it. Like, I would not be okay. I might have a heart attack by the end of the day. I would be calling 911 for help. And the worst thing is my natural reaction to them is to run, like, as fast as possible. And so I'm pretty dangerous, I guess. Like, I wouldn't put it past myself to bolt out into traffic, or, you know, my husband has gotten so used to it that if I hear it coming, like, that's the thing, I hear them before I see them, so I will just bolt no matter what. And he has gotten so used to me doing that over the years that now he tries to tackle me before I can run, and hold me down, which makes it even worse because, you know, the whole theory of if you stand still, they'll go away. I don't appreciate that theory. I don't appreciate being tackled and held down either, but no, I was gonna say the worst part is if you're driving and one comes in your window. Oh my gosh. It is so hard for me not to jump off the car. Which has happened. Thankfully, I at least stopped the car and then jumped out. I'm sure I look like a lunatic half of the time. Like I said, I'm sure we all have our quirks. That one's mine. Like, I'm not afraid of anything else. I'm not afraid of heights. I'm not afraid of snakes or bugs or I don't know, but I cannot handle wasps and bees. And now that I've moved down here to the basement, there seem to be lots of them. Alright, now it's time for the fun part. I don't know if this is what I used last time, but this is what we're going to use this time. It's probably close. Can't find my camera, y'all. There it is. Maybe I can zoom out a little for ya. This is just the glitter mixed with alcohol. Gotta make it all pretty. Yep, that's pretty much what they look like. I guess now that I went over it, it is looking more green. Maybe I shouldn't have gotten it a little wet, but I don't know. Yeah, this one's definitely more green now. Zoom out some more because I can tell I'm not on the camera at all. Doesn't do any good if you can't see what I'm doing, huh? Thingy is that I normally paint on. I'll try to get some sparkle on there too. I know I washed everything. Hmm. usually I like to keep them on something so I can just rotate it and not have to handle them as much. I don't know where I would have put it though. I like it a lot better. Need some more
juice.
This is just an alcohol bottle. It does have a little glitter in there. So I just keep wetting the glitter back down. Think of all the things I've made so far. These are one of my favorites. Just because they look so cute. I knew those cherry cola bottles were probably gonna break the necks off. But I just could not stop myself from doing it anyway because they were adorable. So I'm sad that they broke, but I knew what I was getting into before I did it. Things like that typically always snap the necks in half during shipping. So I'm trying to avoid doing those types of things in the future, but I just could not. I mean, it was a soda box. I had to put the bottle in there. Forgive me. I mean, it was kind of that inspired the whole thing anyway. I mean, the soda box was actually Mackenzie's idea. Which I appreciate. Speaking of ideas, if any of you guys ever get one for like a rubble box, just let me know because I love ideas. I love bringing them to life, so to say, and Lord knows I always need ideas. I mean, I have a lot, but I appreciate everybody else's too. Alright, so that is kind of what we have going on here. And let's see, I still have other bombs to paint today, so I'm sure I'll be back.